Hello students, today I am going to deliver my lecture number 13, Unit 2, Lesson 8, Pakistan and her neighbors. Open your page 70. Today we are going to reading and now we start reading. Pakistan is situated in the continent of Asia. It lies between latitude and between longitude. The country covers an area of about 7,96,9500 square kilometers and stretches from the Arabian Sea in the south to the Tibetan Plateau in the north. In the west, Pakistan is bounded by 800 km of desert along the Iranian border and by 2,200 km border with Afghanistan. In the north, a narrow 15 km strip of Afghanistan separates Pakistan from the Central Asian Republic of Tajikistan. To the northeast, the Great Karakoram Range forms a border with China. Also in this area is the disputed state of Jammu and Kashmir. From Jammu, the border runs south through the Punjab and the Thar Desert for 1500 km to the Arabian Sea. In the south, there is an 800 km long coastline. Pakistan share borders with four other countries. These countries are our neighbors and it is good for us to know something about them. Sometimes neighbors get on well with each other. Sometimes there is conflict. Let us find out what life is like in our neighboring countries. Iran, like Pakistan, is an Islamic republic. Until 1935, Iran was called Persia. Iran is a country of deserts and plateaus surrounded by mountains. It has a coastline in the north along the Caspian Sea and a long coastline along the Gulf in the south. This waterway was once known as the Persian Gulf. Most of the people live in the northwest of the country. This area has the most rainfall and it is the most fertile. Open your next page, page 71. Afghanistan. Afghanistan is a mountainous country. It has cold winters and the summer season is hot and dry. The population of Afghanistan is made up of mixed groups, such as the Pashtuns, Uzbeks, and Tajiks. Because of its central position, travels have passed through this land for thousands of years. All the major routes from the Middle East to the subcontinent pass through Afghanistan. In the 13th century, Afghanistan was a part of the empire of the great Mongol ruler Genghis Khan. It became a strong country under Ahmad Shah Durrani in 1747 and later came under the influence of the British. The people of Afghanistan defeated the British and became totally independent in 1921. The Russian also showed a great interest in this region. In 1979, the USSR occupied Afghanistan. For 10 years, there was unrest and war as the Afghans fought against the Russians. In 1989, the Russians began to withdraw. Today, Afghanistan is again an independent country, but there has been a lot of trouble in the land, especially after September 2001 when it was attacked by the USA, and after 2002 a new government was put in place. Open your next page, page 72. China. Pakistan shares only a small border with China. The mountains in this border region are the Karakoram, which are very high and very beautiful. In 1978, the Karakoram Highway was opened connecting Pakistan and China. This highway, built by the Chinese and Pakistanis, run through the Khanjrab Pass, which is 4693 meters high. Pakistan and China have strengthened their relationship through CPEC, China Economic Corridor. China is much larger than Pakistan. Its total area is 96 square kilometer. It has a cold climate in the north and a warm, wet climate in the south. The world famous Gobi Desert is in the west of the country. China is mainly an agriculture country with most of the population living in the northeast. Chinese farmers mainly grow rice in the south and other food crops such as wheat and millet. The country has large deposits of coal, oil and iron ore. Now your lecture is over.